So the first question I would like to ask you is, can someone tell me what a friend is?
Yes.
You can hang out with your friends and do whatever with them.
Absolutely. So you have fun with your friends, right?
We created the Friends Like You, Friends Like Me program really to promote awareness and understanding and acceptance among children, to really try to foster meaningful social inclusion for all children, not just children with special needs.
You're about to watch children in an elementary school class participate in an interactive discussion. As they learn about autism and other types of disabilities, they discover how to appreciate differences and find similarities that can lead to friendships. This Train the Trainer film provides tools for you to use to facilitate positive relationships between children of all abilities. The program is adaptable to children of different ages, communities, and types of special needs. The common thread is reinforcing everyone's desire to be accepted and to have friends.
Do you guys cheer a friend up when they're sad? So you can be a friend and have a friend. They're kind of the same thing. You would like to be treated the same way.
The program started with a letter written to me by a fifth grader at the time who has a brother who has autism, and he wanted to find a way to help his brother.
I wrote a letter to Ms. Meyer and said that I wanted to do something like a fundraiser.
Once I received this letter, we were going to find a way to help Patrick, help his family and help his brother and other children that have autism.
Are all you and your friends the same or different? Yeah.
They're different because everyone has like a different personality, but you can still be friends.
Right. And how are you guys the same?
If you both like the same things, like if you both like sports or if you both like the certain food or movie or
whatever. So can you be the same and different?
The exciting thing is that it can be a nice component added to your character education program. And once you bring that program in and you teach the children about other children that might have some differences and how they can assimilate into the culture and climate of your school, then it adds to the program you already have in place.
As part of the flexibility of this program, we really feel that it could be implemented in schools where there already is some type of character education program or anti-bullying program, and that this is just a really nice interface with those kinds of programs. It could also be used in schools where that is kind of a new concept, or maybe they haven't incorporated that as much as some other school districts have.
Okay, let's talk about ice cream. Who here likes ice cream? Everybody likes ice cream. Now, tell me, who likes vanilla? Who is chocolate? Who eats the ice cream from the side when you lick your ice cream cone? Who licks from the top? Okay, so you all like ice cream, right? You like different flavors, different cones, and you eat it differently. So we're the same and different. That's okay, difference okay. But even though you're all different, could you all go out and eat ice cream together? It doesn't matter if one person likes one flavor or the other flavor?
No.
So different is okay, and that's a good thing.
One of the messages is that different is okay because we are all different and we have friends for different reasons. You might have your friend that you like to watch sports with and your friend that you like to just kind of sit and be quiet with, or your friend that you go on vacation with your families, and that's okay to have those different friends for different reasons. And having a friend with autism, you might maybe play a little bit differently, but that you can still be friends and have that, share that common ground.
Now, here's the next question. Are you guys good at the same things, you and your friends? Who can tell me something they're really good at?
I'm pretty good at drawing, but I'm not good at math.
Is it okay not to be good at everything? Yeah, it's okay. Now, how about the things that you're really, really good at? Can you help somebody else who's not so good at it?
Yes.
We use our character education program to help us teach children about respect and kindness. And the beauty of our program is that it's interwoven in everything we do. From the time students walk through the door until the time they leave at the end of the day, the principles we are teaching them are found in their classrooms, they're found on the playgrounds, they're found in the cafeteria, they're found in the hallways.
Of course, the program is focusing on autism and autism awareness and tolerance and being friends with children with autism, but I think that the program touches on so much more than that and really looks at just children with all needs, disabilities, abilities, and recognizing, you know, the common ground that we all share, and that we can make friends with everyone even when they're different. We don't need to be frightened. Or scared to talk to someone who might act a little bit different, that we can keep trying or try in a different way and make, you know, the school day a much friendlier place for all.
These principles apply to all aspects of a child's life, and the message can be adapted to any special needs population.
Does everybody have strengths and weaknesses? And that's okay, right? Absolutely. Now tell me something. So what do you call something, the things that you're really strong at? What do you call those?
Abilities.
Now the things that you might have a really hard time doing, or when your body or your mind won't let you do something that you want to do, what might you call that? Yes.
Your disabilities?
We can call disabilities many things, but usually a disability is when your arm doesn't work, or your leg doesn't work, or your mind doesn't work. So tell me something. A physical disability is something you can see, correct? Okay, so that's a visible disability. Let's pretend now that I went skiing, and I went down this really big slope, and I fell down, and I broke my arm and my leg. Okay, now you're all my friends, and I am in a wheelchair a little bit because I can't get around. Can we go bowling? No? Oh, come on. I love bowling with you guys. I got an idea. Who could be my friend and push the wheelchair at the bowling alley? You can. Thank you. And which one of you, my friends, can get, you know, they have a ramp up at the main desk. Who can get the ramp for me for the ball? Thank you. You could do that for me. So now I'm set up. I'm ready to go bowling. I'm going to sit here in my wheelchair, and I'll have my friend who got pushed my wheelchair up. I have my friend who got the ramp and the ball, and then now, what did I get?
A strike.
I got a strike, okay? So that is so great. So I just bowled with you guys. Did it matter that I was in a wheelchair and I couldn't bowl the same way that you did? But did we still have fun together?
Yes.
That's what's important. So different is okay.
At school, it's important to foster friendships, and for the leaders of the school, whether it's the teachers, the administrators, the secretaries, the custodians, to assist in this area.
We really feel that schools deal with the whole child, and so it's not just a question of teaching academics, but also teaching kids how to get along with each other. So I think that anybody who is interested in taking this type of program and introducing it into their school program could do that and make it their own. So whether it's a teacher or a guidance counselor or a school administrator or a parent, it depends on the school district whether they want to approach the principal or the superintendent or the director of special services. We found that really, depending on the school district, any one of those people could be the way to start off.
Now, can you all tell me, are all disabilities physical? Can we see them? Are they all visible?
No.
No, they're invisible disabilities. So let's talk about some of those. What do you call the disability where a person has trouble hearing? Yes.
Deaf.
Deaf. Okay, so a person who is deaf has a hearing disability. The person who can't or has trouble speaking, they call that mute. What ways are there available for a person to communicate?
Sign language.
So we can use sign language. Okay, how about somebody else?
You can use writing.
We can use writing. Excellent. Any other thing that we want to use? Yes.
You could draw what you're talking about.
Right, so we can use pictures. So if I had a picture of pizza, and I gave you the card that says pizza, what do you think I might want to eat? Everybody!
Pizza!
So I could use pictures to communicate without any words.
Knowledge is power, and understanding more about the children around you, whether that they're typically developing children or children with special needs, we really feel will help to reduce any kind of anxiety or fear that somebody might have about being around somebody who acts differently or talks differently, expresses themselves differently, behaves differently.
What do you call an invisible disability where someone might have a little bit of trouble focusing or staying still or quiet for a long period of time? What might that be called? Yes.
ADHD.
ADD or ADHD, great. Okay, does anybody know what that is?
You could have trouble sitting still, like through a long movie or something.
Right, and how could you be a friend to someone maybe in that long movie? What might you be able to do?
You could maybe get up and take a break and walk around and then go back in like 5 minutes and keep watching for a while.
That's a great idea. So that's a great way to be a friend. All these people who have some kind of challenges, what do you think their strengths are? Do they have strengths?
Yes,
they do. Just like you have things that you're good at and not so good at, so does a person with a disability. They have things that they're good at too. So just as much as you can help somebody who might have a visible or invisible disability, could they help you?
Yes.
Yes, they can. So they may be really good at puzzles. They might be really good at a computer game. They might be really good at a certain subject in school, and they can help you. They might not be able to speak the same, or they might not be able to communicate the same, but at least we know that they have strengths and weaknesses just like you.
Reinforce the message that every person has abilities and difficulties. Each of us can share our strengths and support others' challenges.
We found that when we do this program in a classroom, sometimes parents who've been on the edge about whether or not to talk to the child about his or her diagnosis can see that there's a way to do this that's supportive, so that they could kind of take this as a model for talking about, you know, people have different strengths, people have different challenges, and it's really so important, we feel, for the child to have some way of understanding what's going on with himself or herself, to really build self-advocacy from an early age.
Okay, one more invisible disability. Let me have one other that you know. Yes?
Autism.
Autism. Has anybody here heard of autism? Okay. Does anybody here know anybody who has autism? All right, so let's talk about autism for a little bit, okay? So sometimes kids with autism might say things out of context, or they might not always know the most appropriate time to say something, or they might not even know that it's a right thing to say or a wrong thing to say. They also might repeat the things that you say. Does anybody know what an echo is? Raise your hand if you know what echoing is. Okay, so there's something that is called echolalia. So if you talk to them, they might repeat it. Now, some people with autism may not understand some of the expressions that you use. For instance, if I said, come over my house, does that mean we're going over the house? Or you're coming to my house? To your house, right.
If my friends, don't know him, it would be harder for them to understand. But, most of my friends know him and like him a lot. He likes to be around us, so, we could let him join us. It's important to understand autism, because if you know about autism and you see somebody, on the street or at a game or something, you would be able to approach them and talk to them. They'll understand, they're trying to help.
Now some kids with autism, those senses that you have are more sensitive than your senses are. Sounds might be too loud for them. So maybe a crowded, where does it get loud in your school?
At lunchtime?
At lunchtime in the cafeteria. It might get really loud, so a person with autism might have a hard time sitting in a really loud place. Okay, so tell me, how can we help the environment of the cafeteria for someone who might be really sensitive to the sound?
You could tell the people around you to quiet down.
Right, so we can kind of talk a little softer and really control the volume in the room. Excellent.
Work with children to brainstorm about practical and meaningful ways to support each other in both structured and unstructured environments. Activities and lessons about disabilities and inclusion should be incorporated into natural settings.
Who can tell me what is a social rule in the library? When you go to the library, give me a social rule.
You have to stay quiet.
That's right. So a social rule in the library is to stay quiet. Who can tell me a social rule in the classroom? When the teacher asks a question, what are you supposed to do?
Raise your hand.
Raise your hand. So that's a social rule. We don't just call out, we raise our hand. Now, sometimes kids who have autism don't always know those social rules. They might not understand that they need to be quiet in a library
or they might not know on the playground how to come and ask to play. We could all help each other understand those social rules, right?
Yes.
And it's not always somebody with autism. It could be anyone who doesn't understand a rule or what's expected of them. We can help each other.
Sometimes you do have children that have autism and they do feel like they're isolated or they do feel like they're excluded. And sometimes they do have differences that other children just don't understand the differences. And when children don't understand the differences, it can be a little scary for them. So a lot of things we will do as a school is we will educate the other students so they have more knowledge of what the child's perhaps disability is that is in their classroom.
You know, we do have families who have children, you know, with autism and other disabilities in this school that are very private about that. And we're not going around trying to pinpoint, you know, who might have, you know, a hearing problem or a learning problem or autism. It's just, hey, recognize that we all have, you know, some things that we're struggling with and some things that we're really good at. And how can we be friends? How can we get along, you know, regardless?
Can you guys ask me some questions? What questions do you have about autism and kids with autism? Yes.
Why do all kids with autism like want to be alone, or can you hang out with them all the time?
Well, the answer to that is probably no. They might just not know how to come up and ask you, or they might not know the social rules of friendship. So I would probably encourage you to think a little differently and maybe go up to somebody who might be out, you know, or being alone and trying to either do something they're doing or inviting them to be part of what you're doing.
How do I play with someone who has autism?
You can play with someone who has autism the same way as you play with anybody else. But remember, they might not understand the rules, or they might play a little different. So either you can adjust the rules of the game for them or explain the rules a little simpler. And sometimes somebody who has autism might be able to show you how they're playing, and you might play the way they're playing, and you might learn a way to play the game that you never thought of before. Remember we talked earlier about different forms of communication? Well, we have some forms of communication that might be through our body expressions or sign language or pictures, but sometimes our body language tells a lot. So when we're upset, sometimes our body language is alone and we're alone, or sometimes our body language is very open and excited.
Help friends of children with autism realize that they can communicate more effectively if they label their feelings or show them through gestures.
Well, sometimes kids with autism may not be able to read your facial expressions. They may not know when you're sad or angry by what your face looks like or what your body is saying. How can we help a person who has autism understand when you're sad or angry at something? What might you be able to say or do?
Tell them that you're angry.
Right, so instead of just using our facial expressions or body language, sometimes we have to use our words too and tell them why we might be upset or why we might be angry. Yeah, go ahead.
Can I catch autism?
The answer to that question, everybody tell me.
No.
No, you can't catch autism. Pretty much with all visible and invisible disabilities, you can't catch it. So you can go up and you can help and be a friend with kids with autism or any disability, just as you do with any friend, and you can't catch it. Okay, we all talked earlier about we're all different and we're all the same. But when you're upset or angry, how do you calm yourself down? Do we all calm ourselves down the same or differently?
Different.
Different, we all are different. So when you're upset or angry, how do you calm yourself down?
I go in my room and then listen to music.
I do too, I listen to music, so that's great. Who else can tell me what they do to calm themselves down? Yes.
I watch television.
How about over here? How do you calm yourself down when you're upset?
I read a book.
So we all have different ways to calm ourselves down. It's a form of expression. Well, even people who have autism have ways to calm themselves down. So just like we're all different, people with autism are also very different. So one way they might calm themselves down, or one form of expression, even if they're excited, some kids with autism will flap their hands like this. Another way that a person with autism might express themselves is by rocking back and forth. Or perhaps they might vocalize. They might say things really loud. And maybe they're doing it because it's so loud in the cafeteria, they might need to talk even louder. That might just be a form of expression that something's bothering them. Is that something that we should just look at and stare at?
No.
No, that's correct. So it's not something that we should talk about behind their backs or with our friends to each other. We just have to learn about each person, learn about our friends, and find out what their strengths are and their weaknesses and how they express themselves. Because then we begin to understand who that person is, what upsets them, and how they act and react to things. Do we accept our friends for who they are?
Yes.
Absolutely.
I think autism awareness is so important for the students because it teaches children about respect for others, teaches them about acceptance and tolerance.
The Friends Like You, Friends Like Me program can be used in any setting. It's not just designed for a classroom. It could also be in settings such as scouting, cheerleading, sports team, any group of kids where you really want to encourage awareness and meaningful inclusion.
The program is so easy to implement. It really goes along with what you're already doing in all capacities in all of your character ed programs. So it's easy, it's fun, it makes sense for the children, and it's something that they can take with them as they grow.
Part of the Friends Like You, Friends Like Me program is not just what we're showing in the video where we're going into the classroom and working with the kids directly, but we also developed a lot of other resources that a teacher in a school district can use to support this visit with the kids. So we really encourage people to visit the website of Children's Specialized Hospital where they can download any of these resources.
Visit www.friendslikeyoufriendslikeme.org. There you will find supportive materials for the Friends Like You, Friends Like Me program. Empower children with the knowledge and openness to understand differences, discover similarities, and appreciate individuality. Implementing this program can help ensure that every child, including those with special needs, feels welcome, accepted, and valued as a friend.
Then you